Hey.
Okay, fine, no problem.
Can you hang up the phone?
Yeah, sure, we'll do.
Michael, you still there?
I guess so. What's happening?
Oh, nothing much going along. I'm trying to decide who to be tonight.
What?
For Julie's costume party, aren't you going?
Well,
why
are you inviting me?
Well, I'm inviting you. But if you want to go, you have to have a costumer. You know, come as somebody.
Why?
Because that's the rule tonight.
Well, who are you coming in?
The Spectre de la Rose. Oh, or maybe the Arab one. You know, what's it called? Scheherazade? Oh, except I don't have the right stuff. Hey, maybe I could go as Nijinsky when he was in the mental place. You know, get some rags.
I'll let anyone know who you are.
I'll tell them. Pretend I'm Russian. I don't know. Maybe you're right. How about Nijinsky and Diaghilev arriving in Monte Carlo? You could be Diaghilev.
Thanks a lot. I must be old and fat. Well, you be Diaghilev and I'll be Nijinsky. After all, I'm the dance.
Did you get in?
Yes, well, I think so. They haven't decided about the scholarship yet, but I think I'll get it. Jan told me that she saw my name on her list.
Did Jack get in?
No. He said he wouldn't be auditioning me today.
Oh, I don't believe it. Why?
I don't know. He wanted so much of this, he couldn't relax and do it. He's really fucked up. And kind of mad at me for getting in.
Oh, auditions are the worst. I mean, I could never do it. But why should he be mad at you?
Well, you know, he's been dancing a lot longer than I have. I mean, he's the one sort of made me start in the first place. Now, I'm the one getting all breaks, and he's back at square one. Plus, he thinks you and I are getting it all.
Oh, no. Worst. Why does he think that? I mean, I'd never have sex with you, Michael. That would break everything. I just want to be your friend forever. I mean it. Well, that's the best, don't you think? I mean, it's hard enough without... Well, anyway, Michael, I never came on to him. Jeff's the one that came on to me. And I would have done it, too, if what's-his-name hadn't been there, Franz.
When was
that? Julie's last party. Don't you remember? You know, there was a dance at the officers' club, so our parents were out. We got there really late. Well, Franz didn't want to go because he's afraid, you know. He didn't want to be identified with me. But I say, fuck that. I'm always the same no matter who I'm with. So, anyway, when we finally got there, well, Franz was drunk. And Jeff acted like he'd been waiting for me all night. Like we did some kind of date I'd broken.
He says you're a cop, too.
Who said that, Jen? I don't even know what that means. Oh, people see what they want to see. It was so weird. You should have seen Jeff with that girl he hangs around with. Marlene says that she hates fags and that Franz was the only real man there. And that she was going to prove it.
Jeff and I aren't having sex anymore.
You're kidding. Michael, I want to talk more later. I gotta go.
Okay, you coming back?
Yeah, a little while.
Oh.
I don't know, a while, an hour or so.
Well, I'll be here.
Goodbye, cheer up. Everything's gonna be great.
I hope so. Bye-bye.
Hey, Pete, what are you up to?
Nothing.
Nothing? You must be doing something.
I'm thinking.
Thinking? About what?
About how to get the fuck out of here.
Don't swear, Peter. Low-class people swear.
God, that's not true.
That's how we judge people, Peter, by how they look, how they talk, how they behave. What would I think if I had just met you?
How can you judge me when you don't even know anything about me?
I'm not judging you.
Yes,
I'm just
you
saying,
are.
Don't interrupt. Very rude to interrupt, especially your elder. What's the music you're playing?
It's Gloria Gaynor.
That's better than Mick Jagger you used to listen to all the time. Peter, I want to talk. You read those pamphlets I gave you, huh?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Huh?
I don't want to go into the army.
But what do you want to do? School doesn't seem to be the answer. You're ready to try again.
I don't know. Why do we have to have the same conversation over and over again?
Because you never give the right answer. Look, Peter, you're not a child anymore. I'm not going to support you forever, you know.
Oh, Mom said not to worry. You had a lot of money.
Your mother had a lot of funny ideas about money, about raising kids. But in spite of that, you know, you're the only thing left of her I have. Well, what I want to say is, you know, I'll never have another child.
Who knows? Maybe you'll get married again.
No, I don't think so. After you've lost someone, Peter. You're still mad about the other night?
No. I'm not mad.
It won't happen again, I swear it.
Don't swear.
I promise, then. Peter, look at me when I'm talking to you. I'm trying to say I'm sorry, I mean it. Remember when you were little, you used to like me.
No, I don't remember.
Look, Peter, I know it was wrong, but try to understand my situation. I mean, you're a man now, aren't you? I'm alone now, I only have you. I know I should try to get on with my life, but your mother and I, hard. And there's gotta be someone, and I know I won't have you much longer. Oh, sure, you can stay as long as you want. I'd never put you out. But, why are you making this so hard for me?
I'm not doing anything to you. You're the one that's doing stuff to me.
Just help him, for Christ's sake. It's over. Finished. I said that already. Doesn't mean anything. We're the family. We gotta keep that together. Family's most basic, the most important element of your life. It's the thing that sustains you.
Oh, really? You just said you weren't gonna support me anymore.
No, I never said that. I'm not talking about money. Money has nothing to do with this.
Well, that's easy for you to say. The government, the army supports you. Keep sending your checks forever. That's your family.
That's my job. I'm talking about love.
Oh. So, that's my job, huh? Love's a job? Well, what's the pay? I'd say I'm owed a lot.
I don't owe you a dime, Peter. That's what you think. You're wrong. All I owe you is an apology. I've given you that already. Now let's just get on with it, shall we?
It doesn't matter what you say. Words don't mean anything.
It does matter what I say, and you better start listening, Buster! Now that's enough. I got better things to do than stand around here arguing with you. Stop being ridiculous. I mean it. All right, you're gonna act like a child that treats you like one. Come on, clean up your room. Someone's coming over. For Christ's sake, get dressed.
Is your father here? He does not like me, I think.
Oh, don't worry about it. No, that's just his way. He thinks that being cold and distant is a form of politeness. He probably doesn't even know who you are.
Yeah, he does. He says, "Five with the artists want to see my son." What could I say? I couldn't tell the truth.
Yeah, I guess not. Well, did you finish?
Yeah.
Well, let me see.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my. it certainly is, provocative.
I should tell him I'm the artist and your son is the art.
Oh, God, you're so romantic. Maybe you should cut off your ear.
You mean castration?
Oh, castration, not even too much. No, that's not what I meant. I meant romantic with a capital R, you know, like art history.
Oh, say there's no history. An artist must destroy history before something new can be born.
Oh, a revolutionary artist. Very butch.
All true art is revolutionary.
Well, if you say so, I mean, all this philosophy is making me delirious.
That's why I love you. You are pure, untainted by all this culture.
A noble savage. Hey, maybe that's what I'll be tonight. I can get some Indian feathers and some old hippie beads.
I don't understand.
Oh, that's okay. Oh, say, what are you going to do with that picture?
Of course, I'm going to sell it.
You're kidding! Who would buy that?
You'd be surprised. I have ideas.
Do I get any money from it?
Sure. Why not? I want to do a whole series of drawings. You, in all different faces. When can we have another sitting?
You name it.
Good, lie down now.
Now? Like this?
No. On your front. On your front. Oh. Yeah, just so, but more or less. Oh, of course, you must be naked.
Oh, I know, for the real thing. But for now, I thought, I mean, what if...
I'll take care of it, please. Allow me.
There's a time and place for everything, you know.
We live outside time. We can make our own rules.
I don't know. Well, okay. For a little while, I guess.
Says, that went over like a fart in church. Now, John, the reason I asked you over is I want to discuss some of these reassignments with you. Take Gallagher, for instance. Now, I know he's been something of a disciplinary problem, but to move him out of the unit is not the answer.
It seemed like the best thing to do at the time, sir.
You can't allow one little event to change a whole course of action, John. You've got to look at the big picture. I believe in your report on him, you used the term extortion. What do you mean by that?
He forced some of the men into giving him money, sir.
By what mean?
By threats of acts of physical violence.
Right here?
Yes, sir.
You know, John, there's always this sort of gossip, innuendo, really, when there's basically nothing for the men to do.
I'm not sure I understand what you're getting at, sir.
Getting rid of Gallagher won't solve anything, John. It's the situation. Individual personalities are irrelevant. We need more information. Try to delve a little deeper. Use a little psychology. Remember, he's just a kid. I don't be afraid. I'm behind you 100%. You remember that he's just a kid.
Yes, sir.
Have you met my son, Peter?
No, sir. Well, I've seen him.
Yes, I know. John, I'd like to ask you a little favor. I think it'd do Peter a world good if you would talk to him. He needs a little, well, direction, and I was thinking that maybe you could encourage him to sign up. I've always thought that he just naturally wanted to join the army when his time came. Oh, you know, kids are. Anything I want, he doesn't. Worry about some of these friends he's made. Wish he could have grown up in the States. Finally becoming a man. That's the big hump. What do you say?
Okay, sir, I'll talk to him. Anytime you want, sir, you name it.
How about right now? Happens to be here. Just a coincidence. I hope this won't inconvenience you. I don't want you to go to any trouble.
No, no trouble at all, sir. Where is he?
Well, I believe he's in his room. Excuse me.
Peter.
I want to introduce you to one of my best members, Lieutenant John Grego Johnson, my son. Peter Johnson.
Hi, Peter. Why don't you call me Jack?
Hello, how do you do?
And this is Wolf von Leiter, a German friend.
Hi, Sochan.
Hi, Peter John here. Wanted to meet you. Wanted to talk to you. Well, for the crowd, I guess. I've got some work to do upstairs. Peter, you and I'll have supper a little later. I'd like to invite you guys, but...
Oh, that's okay, sir. Thanks anyway.
Yeah, thanks, Pops.
It's a shame there's no draft in Germany.
Yes, it is a little stuffy in here. It's a small room for four adults. See you later, Dad.
Right. I get it. No problem. Say, John, can I fix you a little,
Oh, no thanks, sir. I'll be fine. Don't worry.
All right. See you guys later.
Bye-bye.
Well, I don't know what to say. What were you guys doing? Schoolwork?
I don't go to school. I'm an artist. I have a certain drawings of Peter.
Oh, like that?
Yeah, just like that.
Jesus.
It's like school. It's called life drawing. They teach it everywhere, even in the army. Well, Wolf's helping me learn how to model. I mean, you get paid to do it.
Oh, really? How much? I bet they don't pay very much.
Oh, well, whatever it is, it's enough. I mean, for not really doing anything. I mean, you just pose the way they want you to and hold it. Well, that's the hard part, holding the pose for a long time, hours even.
Days, weeks, months, years. To capture an image could take an artist a lifetime.
Sounds like slow work.
You have to know how to concentrate.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure you're right. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to disturb your work. I didn't know you were busy. I mean, I didn't even know you were here. The colonel just said I'd...
Oh, that's okay. I must leave that anyway.
Peter, can I see you again?
Yeah, all right. You got the number?
Yeah, somewhere. What time?
Late, I think, okay?
Okay. Bye, Peter.
Auf Wiedersehen, Soldier! Until we meet again! See ya!
Well, he seems like a nice fella. How long have you known him?
Not too long. Not long at all. What does that have to do with anything?
Nothing, I guess. Sorry. Well, so, how long have you been in Berlin?
3 years, off and on.
Are you in school?
I finished.
Right. Where'd you go?
Well, I went to school here, and I went to school in the French zone.
Oh, you speak French?
No. You don't have to go there. You have to take it, though. Are you some kind of psychiatrist?
No. Why?
Well, you sure like questions.
I'm just interested.
How old are you?
21. How old are you?
19.
You must have a lot of good times being young here in Berlin, yeah?
Oh, I don't know. I'm not that young. Sometimes I guess.
Oh, it's a real wide open town. What do you do for fun? Do you like sports?
I hate sports. I like to dance, though. Does that count? I mean, you move around. I'll bet you're a big jock, right?
No, I wouldn't say that. Sometimes the guys get together for touch football.
Oh, that's what President Kennedy used to play, right? I mean, before he was president, or before he was in the PT boat or something.
Or before he broke his back. Well, whatever. I don't know too much history.
Really? Oh,
Well, history was always my best subject.
It was my favorite. Well, I guess I better get dressed now.
Oh, you want me to leave?
No.
You don't have to.
Do you want to?
Whatever you want.
No.
Whatever you want. Okay, no. I mean, yeah. Thanks. Can I look at your records?
Sure.
Wow, you got a lot of records. How'd you get so many?
Oh, I rip them off from the PX. It's really easy.
Easy for you.
Yeah, I guess. Well, sometimes I can get 3 or 4 a day. And if I don't like them, I just throw them out. Hey, tell me, do you like this shirt?
Hey, that's cool. I like that. I mean, it's a little too far out for me, but for you, you know, you're a good-looking guy. You must make out pretty good with the Fräuleins, yeah? You know many girls?
Yeah, I know some.
Hey, maybe we could go out sometime. You know, like a double date. Only trouble is, I don't dance too good.
Do you know how to hustle?
What?
The hustle. It's a dance.
I never heard of it.
God, where have you been?
I've been around. Maybe you could teach me.
Teach you? Yeah, well, maybe I could. Okay. Okay. Oops. Come here. It's really easy. Just watch my feet.
You sure this is cool with your dad?
I play music in here all the time. I'm not afraid. Come on. Let's go. And 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. That's right. That's great. Now here, do it out with this one. Now give me your arm.
Days are over, buddy boy! I'm watching you turn into some stupid little Claire.
Don't you want me to grow up to be just like my daddy?
You shut up!
I won't shut up, you old fag. You're just a hypocrite. Yeah, yeah, you want to keep me around here. Yeah, so that when you get hard up and you can't find some drunk cake GI to suck off, you can grind into my room and jack off up my asshole. You make me sick. I'm going to call the cops on you.
That's not even funny. You're not calling anybody.
Oh, yeah, yeah, you want to bet? My friends will help me out. I told them all about you.
Andy!
Yeah, them! At least it doesn't take an hour for him to get it up. Oh, you'd love it! Nice, pink, smooth young dicks all over the place!
Shut up! You can't talk to me like this. I won't stand for it, you hear me? I won't stand for it!
Get fucked! I can do anything I want, and you can't do anything about it. Oh, now you're mad, huh? Hard up? Don't know what to do or how to do it? Yeah. Well, maybe your new assistant, John, will help you out. Yeah, maybe get him to stick it up your old fat ass! Or maybe we can both fuck you at the same time! Would you like that?
No!
I'm sure there's enough room
Stop
up
it.
There.
Yeah,
but no reason. But shut up! Up. Too fucking cheap! Too goddamn fucking... Okay.
Here you go!
Sorry, but I need to talk to you. Now.
I can't talk now. I'm sorry. I'll see you later.
Nobody ever knows.
Michael.
Where are you? You were supposed to be here at 1.
Couldn't make it.
Well, you could have called. I just sat here. Could have had lunch with a lot of other people, you know. I set aside today for you. Never mind. Are you coming tonight? Alain Delon's going to be here.
Who?
Who's Alain Delon? Michael, he's maybe going to put me in this movie if I play my cards right. I met him last night at Club Set, and he said I'd be perfect for it.
What movie?
I don't know the name of it. Some Polissier thing. He is so incredible.
Hey, come on, come on.
What? How did he find you?
Well, I saw him in the newspaper. Thank you.
You saw him?
No, he came backstage to find me, but I already left the stage manager here.
Oh, that idiot. Well, what did he have to say?
Well, I'm
not
to
see him. Well, I don't want to see him.
Your father, you have to see him.
I don't have to do anything.
Jesus Christ, Peter. You tried to kill him.
I didn't try to kill him. It was an accident.
I'm sorry.
I am sorry it happened, but it's over, right? I've gotten it together now, and I'm not going to let him fuck this up. I don't care who he is.
Peter, listen to what you're saying. He's still your father.
Don't give me that psychology crap. So what, he's my father? Is that my fault? You can't choose your parents. What's he want to see me for, anyway?
I don't know. He just wants to see you. He's sorry about what happened. I think he feels guilty somehow. Like, it was his fault.
It wasn't his fault.
Peter, something's happened to him. He sounds like he's ill.
I'm not his nurse. Listen, I gotta go.
What about your father?
You didn't give him my number, did you?
No, maybe I should. Maybe I should invite him to your party.
Are you crazy? Anyway, it is not my party. It's a lens. Michael, just relax. Forget about him. I really have to go. I'll see you tonight, okay?
I don't think so.
Please?
I'm working.
Work, work, work. Everyone's always working.
I'm free in the mornings.
I know. Fine, Michael. Don't be mad at me. I love you.
Okay.
Where's Peter?
I don't know. I was looking for Paulette.
Don't you have enough work to keep your little mind occupied? Water and circa, not friends, as Madame would always say.
Sorry, so sorry. What are you wearing?
What do you mean?
Your parfum, what is it?
Balenciaga, of course. I've worn it for 20 years. What, you don't like it all of a sudden?
No, it's fabulous. I just meant you look different today.
It must be my new suit. It's beautiful, isn't it?
I love that line, and the color is perfect for you.
And this is a very old color, you know. Before the war, my mother had a hat. A very big hat, just this color.
The old colors are the best.
Yes, they are. Oh, don't touch me now, please.
Why? Is there something wrong?
Oh, no, no, nothing's the matter, I don't think. Peter, when is the last time you were at the doctor?
I don't know. There's nothing wrong with me.
Now, you're certain you're not ill. Perhaps you're having some sort of relapse.
Relapse of what? Yes, I'm certain. I'm not ill, Owen.
Then what is the matter with you?
Nothing. I feel great.
You're wearing yourself down. You're seeing too many people.
But you're always telling me to go out, to meet new people.
I didn't want you to sleep with them.
Oh, here we go. Who have you been talking to?
No one. No one has to tell me. I can smell it on your body. I wouldn't even care if it wasn't, if you still wanted to be with me. For someone your age, I would think the normal is, say, once in the morning, once at night. Perhaps twice at night.
What's gotten into you?
Oh, at least once a day, that would be suitable. But we never sleep 2 days together. And now these men, it's dangerous.
It doesn't have anything to do with you.
Yes, it does.
Shit. Alain, are you sure you're all right? Maybe it's you who has some kind of disease.
Yes, it's called love.
Oh, brother.
Oh, you can't understand love. You don't want to sacrifice, to give. And these people you meet, they don't love you. I love you. The rest, you are making a big mistake. You're pushing everything out, leaving only a little space, a little world to live in. And that world is a prison. Once you're in, you'll never get out.
You seem to know an awful lot about it.
It's not so difficult to understand. I'm trying to help you, don't you see that? Don't you see anything?
I see that you're mad at me, and I don't know why.
Oh, I'm not mad at you, my darling. I've been thinking.
You think too much.
Always I'm thinking or working. Time is passing, yes? When I was young, I thought this is not my real life. My real life will come later. And now I realize this is my life now, so I must... I used to think this is not perfect. When it is perfect, then I won't have to... But only in, how do you say, stillness is their perfection. I can't be still ever. Oh, maybe in heaven.
Alain, you are so weird. What are you talking about?
Nothing. I can talk to the walls the same.
Are you saying you don't want to have sex with me anymore?
Oh, no. I'm not saying anything about sex. But more about us. There's something wrong with us. Something banal. Something in our way, we're not progressing. It's always the same. Everything's always the same. Don't you feel that?
Oh, yes, but I thought you liked our arrangement.
Oh, yes, but if it goes on like this, what will become of us? I mean, I want you to want something, to make something of your life.
Like what?
Like a career. I thought maybe we could, I don't know, would you like to work here?
Doing what? I don't know how to do anything.
Oh, of course you do. You could be my assistant. You could help me look at the clothes, perhaps. Type my correspondence, manage my affairs. You can't just lie around here waiting for me. You need some reason. Think of me, this house. This is where I entertain all my friends, my business associates, new contacts.
Fuck them. They know why I'm here.
Do you? Oh, Peter, don't you see? Well, just how do you say? Going through the motions.
Alain, what do you want? Do you want to get married?
I don't be absurd. Is that what you want?
What do you want?
I want something more. I want more.
Join the club.
Oh, don't be horrible. Why don't you ever listen to me?
I'm listening to you now.
But you are not trying to understand me. You're just using me. Living off me.
You're pathetic.
How dare you? I'm pathetic. I helped you. I saved you from what you did in Germany. I got you away from all those fags who ate you up and spit you out. Maybe that's where you belong again. Is that it, my pretty one? Are you waiting for the right man to come fuck you up the derriere and take you away from all this? Answer me, you stupid little queer!
Fucking bitch! I'll kill you! I'm sorry. Are you all right? Alain, are you all right?
Yes, I am all right, thank you. I have to get dressed for the party.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes, mon ange. It's time to present you to my world.
I don't have anything to wear.
Oh, sometimes I wonder about you, my dear. Don't you remember yesterday all the clothes we got for you?
I try not to remember anything.
Well, try to remember this. It's 5:30 at 6 is arrive. Try to be prepared.
Oh, God. The cocktail party. Very American.
Angel of my lifetime. and there's so much noise and pies now. They're making on the road, so I just came up, huh? You mind a little before party?
Oh, mach nicht, wohl. Salome Ferien. What's the deal? You can help me choose my ensemble.
Oh.
So what do you think? Italian or Japanese?
Oh, no, I know nothing of such things. Honey, that's Helena.
Oh, well then, that bitch, she can't think beyond Daniela Scher. And besides, I don't think I should disturb her until she's completed her toilette. She doesn't like me today.
And why not? You're more adorable than ever.
Maybe that's why. You know, I never thought of that. The better I look, the worse she feels. Sometimes I wish I were uglier than her, or rather she.
That is not your fate.
Oh, don't talk to me about fate. I don't believe in that. That's for when you're dead. Et voila! Well, what do you think? Honestly.
Pretty as a postcard.
Oh, well, the expression is pretty as a picture.
Oh.
What's that line? Oh, right. I'm so tired of people telling me I'm pretty. Kim Novak. Picnic.
Oh.
Must have been.
Ooh. Something
like that. Oh, I hate this shirt.
Try another then.
Now there's an idea. What a genius you are, Wolf. Everything they say about you is true. What time is it?
Oh, it's a little before six.
Oh, good. So, what else is new with you today?
Well, today I met a man, an agent, who knows a publisher who could publish a book of my work. I mean pictures of my work, but first I must collect some photographs on a resume for what he calls it's a presentation. His publisher is an old queen who is always trying to be modern, so I don't think it's going to be a problem. So maybe next week, perhaps we could go see him. Would you like that for the Badalena?
It doesn't matter. She takes forever to get dressed. She never comes into my room without knocking. And if anyone else comes, we'll hear the bell. Paulette will get it and tell Elaine. So we got tons of time. Really? Okay.
Okay, you know best.
I certainly do. About some things.
Oh, you're pretty confident of yourself, aren't you?
Pretty much. But then so are you. That's what I like about you.
Come with me to Spain. Paris is dead. There's too much interference here. I want you all to myself. I have some plans for you.
You've always got a million plans.
And with some luck, some of them will work out. You just need the right plan at the right time.
Is this part of your master plan?
Yeah, if it gets you away from here.
And why should I put my trust in you?
Oh, because your future is with me.
I wish I could get interested in the future. I wish it was the future right now.
Faith, I can feel the future coming right now. Do you feel it? Do you feel it?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Bonjour.
Oh, bonjour. Je cherche un monsieur Beck.
Who are you?
Je suis son père. I'm his father.
Can you speak English?
Yes, enough.
Maid speaks English.
I am not a maid. I work for Madame Clavert. What do you want?
Well, I'm his father. I'd like to see my son.
I don't believe you. Monsieur Bain's father died in a house of crazy people.
Do I look dead to you?
Yes. Au revoir, monsieur.
Just a minute, sister. I got a call from that big face or whatever. You tell her I got a call. We tell her all the money.
Madame doesn't give to beggars. She gives to the church, to give to the poor. Go to them, go to the church.
What church?
How should I know? There is a church on every street.
I'm not going to. You tell her Colonel Henry Bates of the United States Army is here on official business. Got it? I'll do it.
I'm going to call the police. Give me a call.
Never, me never. Leave this house this moment. I can't believe this. How dare you in my house?
Oh, in your house? Because your husband pays the rent.
Jacques has nothing to do with it. It's still my house. And this house is mine.
No, no, they're not even here. He's mine now. He might abuse me.
Oh, he doesn't know what he wants. He's just a child. He'll never see you again. I'll see to that.
Yeah, just a stupid woman, Helena. You'll be dead soon enough. I can see it in your eyes.
You've seen nothing. I'll live to see you both dead. You promised me. You broke your promise.
What did you promise, Walt?
It doesn't matter.
Oh, Peter, how blind can you be? Worse than I had an arrangement to.
It's over. Doesn't mean anything now. Peter, come with me.
Oh, don't you dare. I can't
right now. I don't understand. What was your arrangement? I can't go anywhere now. Don't force me to.
Oh, no one is forcing you to do anything. You two for me, Peter. Au revoir, mes enfants.
What am I going to do with you? You are as naive as the day I found you.
Yeah. This scene is fucked up. I'm getting out of here.
No, don't go, please. It's not your fault, it's my fault. I feel so stupid. Look at this. Look at me.
Alain, it's not your fault. What is this thing about blaming people all the time?
Everything just happens, is that it? Don't think about why. But once something happens, only so many things can happen after that. Till in the end, only one thing can happen.
What?
I can't bear this. Feeling I have no choice. Waiting. Always waiting for the next thing.
Don't expect so much. I don't expect anything to happen. Ever. I just have to be the way I want to be.
But you are only what others want you to be.
Maybe. Maybe I shouldn't try to please everyone. I don't know. Why should anyone please anyone? But there are only so many types. You keep trying to believe you're unique and they're unique.
It's sad, but this situation, and I'm afraid this conversation, they are not unique. You know, not every experience leads to newer ones. Sometimes, once something happens, it hurts you. It limits you. And instead of making you more of a person, it makes you less of one. Parts of me are slipping away, I can feel it. And nothing is coming back to replace them. I am going away. For the weekend to marry José, I shall leave after the party. I will come back. I don't know when I will come back. I want to come to some decision.
What's the problem? So I fucked up. That doesn't mean we can't continue.
We have to change.
Why?
I am so confused. What an old idiot I am. Perhaps it's just the weather. I can't talk anymore. Everyone's coming. I am starving. Are you going to get rest?
Yes.
You better hurry.
I'll see you out there.
Please. Don't embarrass me anymore tonight.
I won't. I'll be perfect.
Everything is so ridiculous.
Thank you.
Hello?
Hello, who is this?
Is it Wolf?
Wolf, it's me. Hélène, calling from Paris. Is Peter there?
No, he's out.
Is this where he lives?
Yeah. Well, just a moment.
He didn't say he was living with you.
Who? Who said that?
Alain.
Alain who? Fine, you care where he lives?
I'm interested. I've always been interested in Peter.
Is that so? So why did you tell him you never wanted to see him again?
I never said that. That's a lie. Did Peter tell you that?
Yeah, and a lot of other things, too.
Oh, Peter, was there anything to help me? I don't have time for this. I don't blame you for what happened. We both care for him, that's all. Try to accept that. I just want to talk to him as a friend.
He's not here.
I understand. You told me. How is he?
I told you. He's out. He might need a message.
Well, you see, my company, you know the clothing store, they're opening a branch in New York on Madison Avenue. And I'm coming there to make some arrangements.
Oh, yeah.
In the springtime, will you be there?
Yeah, sure. Unless I go away.
Well, I might have some work for Peter.
What sort of work for
him? Oh, nothing very grand, I'm afraid. You know, in the store.
Hey, it's not bad work for you. Besides, it's working for me now.
I think he should decide for whom he works, don't you? I can offer him a lot more money than you can.
You're wrong, monsieur. Listen, Elena, he's meeting a lot of new people now. It's from me. People you could never know, except perhaps as your customers.
Well, a lot of my customers are also your customers. Our worlds are not so different anymore.
Oh.
However, there is a difference in tone. Peter understands that much.
Oh.
So do you, so does everyone.
But the knowledge is a dangerous thing.
As that depends on who has the knowledge. I can't talk anymore. I'm not as rich as everyone thinks. I will call again, perhaps tomorrow morning.
Mm.
Oh no, that would be bad for you.
Oh, no, it's okay. We're going to bed very late, you know.
All right then. Goodbye, Wolf. It was good to talk. We're too old to be emotional. I'm learning so much now. Everything's better. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I don't know which of you is worse.
No one is better than this.
Why didn't you tell her about me?
Why should I? What is it you tell?
She doesn't even know I'm here.
So much the better.
She's sure to find out sooner or later.
Aren't you forgetting about some money? When you're rich, you can tell her anything.
When I'm rich. It doesn't look like I'm going to get rich too soon. Your promises aren't worth shit.
Whew, you are so impatient. In 6 months, you'll have so much money, you won't know what to do with it.
I know what I'll do with it. I'm going to buy land, get into real estate. I'm going to buy all of New Mexico.
Have you ever been in New Mexico?
No, but I've seen pictures of it. I'll be like Frida Lawrence, communicate with the Indians.
Okay. I've met Indians, I'm very nice to you.
You're not so nice yourself. Where's Peter? We were supposed to have dinner together.
So that's why you're here. He's already gone out to dinner.
With who?
A young man.
It doesn't bother you?
No, as long as he doesn't bring them back here, it's okay.
I'm okay, you're okay.
Yeah. Something like that.
Do you want to have dinner with me?
No, I want to have.
I could go out for some Chinese food.
Oh, I'm not hungry.
Some Friday night.
Mary Ann.
Oh, good evening, my little prince. Did you have a good time?
Oh, it was so fabulous. You know, we went to the Empire Diner and I had the best hamburger.
Was it big?
Well, it was big enough for two.
You're late.
Late for what?
You said you'd be back at 10.
I did, but what time is it now?
It's not so late.
You are late.
Well, I'm sorry. But we went to a movie. I mean, he really wanted to see it, so
well, we did.
You said you wanted to have dinner with me.
I did when?
This afternoon, when we were watching One Life to Live.
Oh, wasn't it great today?
It was okay, but I still like The Young and the Restless better.
Well, they have cuter guys, but the stories are so dumb.
Hey, you two, shut up! I have to wait! If I don't bet, they'll take away the TV, and then you have nothing to talk about.
Oh, gee, Wolf, you're so gracious.
And well-mannered.
Manners! Manners are for shit!
Art is long and life is short, and so goodbye, my little love. But I'll leave you to your own device. Peter, I'll call you tomorrow.
Okay, not too early.
No, of course. Well, we'll have fun tonight. I guess I spend the evening going over my portfolio.
Fine.
Ciao, bambino.
Ciao. So, what did you see?
Fox and his friends.
Such, you're right. And how is Gerald?
Oh, you know actors. When I stopped talking about him, he stopped listening.
And after you stopped talking?
Well, he had a hairy ass with big red pimples.
Really? I wouldn't think it was his ass that interested him.
Oh, bitch.
It is another light.
Oh, hey, that's what everybody said. But I am not so sure. Can I have some? Do you want to hear a joke you told me? How does an old queen fart?
I don't know how does an old queen fart.
You've been working all this time.
Yeah. All right, bite, not fly. I must finish this by Friday. Is the prince? Wants to take it home with him on his plane.
Oh, the snotty one?
No, he has his old plane. Take him everything he has possibly. And maybe he could probably take you with him.
Does he have $1 billion?
Yeah, and he gambles every night. One night, he lost $2 million in cash and had his men paid for it the next morning.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What a way to go. Did you ever see that movie? It was with Shirley MacLaine, and they go to Saudi Arabia, and they teach the prince how to play baseball. I think that's it. Well, maybe it was gold. Anyway, it was so funny. You know, stupid but funny. I saw it on TV about 1 million years ago. You know, I used to watch TV all the time on the base. I used to love reading TV Guide. I'd read every little listing over and over again. You know, sometimes I think I've seen something because I know everything about it, but it's only because I read the description about 100 times in the TV Guide. Well... I guess they don't have TV Guide in Germany. Well, maybe they do by now. How much is he paying you for this little Kunstberg?
None of your business. Oh, hold it. Your girlfriend called.
Who?
Helena.
Really? What she want?
Really, she wants to talk to you.
Oh, really? About what?
I don't know. She's coming here. Hey, blessing.
Shit, just what I need. Well, maybe I'll be gone by then.
She said she'd call you back.
Oh, gee. I can't wait. Anybody else call?
No. Oh, yeah, a man called. They said he was your father. I told him your father was dead.
Oh, what did he say to that?
Oh, he said, doesn't matter. I changed my name.
What does that have to do with anything?
Why don't you tell me your father was dead?
Because he is dead. I saw it with my own eyes. No, there's just too many crazy people. I don't have too much time on my hands to waste.
I did sound rather crazy.
I mean, you know, they're too relevant to fool anybody. You know, I don't even think they want to fool anybody. I think they'd rather you become crazy like them. You know, this cold is making me sick. I feel like throwing up. Where'd you get it?
From Dion. She said it was the best uncut.
Are you glad I'm here?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure. Why?
I
thought. Oh, why? You like to
have
me
around?
Because I love to watch you squirm. Well, that's for sure. Is it just the sex?
No, this isn't
sex. Oh, what do you mean this isn't sex? Of course it isn't. Oh, I get it. Well, I'm sorry, Wolf. I'm trying, but I guess I'm just not as advanced as you are.
You should try hard.
I should try. I try to please you all the time, whatever that means, but sometimes it just hurts so much and you don't even come. I don't think. So, I mean, really, what's the point?
You don't understand. I come inside my head. You Americans are so middle class.
If it's not on the TV, you can't see it, it's too strange.
I don't think my life is that middle class.
No, your mind is.
So what? Is that my fault? I mean, everything's middle class. I mean, even your fucking butt plugs from Anaheim, California. I mean, really.
That reminds me of it. It's missing. You didn't sell it over to Cooper Union, did you?
I sent it to the cleaners.
Huh?
Well, I picked up all the clothes and stuff off the floor by the bed, and I think it got in the laundry bag by mistake. I wonder if it'll get ruined in the dryer.
I would like to put you in the dryer and let you turn around and around and around.
Really? Do you want to go to the cock ring tonight?
Maybe later.
I'd love to go dancing, I think.
Oh, I'd love to fuck you first.
Oh, no. I know you. Then you'll just read Art Forum and fall asleep.
Yeah, but all of those beds, they make me hot again, and some of those pictures.
Oh, Walt, you're hurting me.
No, I'm not. Come on, baby. Come to Papa. Oh, his Majesty's expecting you. He doesn't like the man.
I can't.
Come on, take it. You want it? Come on, stop! Stop playing around with me! I don't feel good. I gotta get out of these trashy clothes. Whatever you wear, you're still trash.
No, I'm not! Just because I'm not like you, a cheap little hustler trying to fool everybody with your phony accent and your phony art.
I'm phony! How are you, princess? A stupid little slit! That's all you ever heard.
No, I'm not. Out of date. You don't get it, do you? You're just playing the middle class game. They love being shocked by your art like they love being shocked by an inheritance. It's a little momentary distraction for them. Like looking out the windows of the train.
No, I don't make the rules.
The only thing is you're on the train, too. They're just looking in. Me? I'm getting the fuck off this train.
You're not going anywhere.
Oh, yes, I am. As soon as I figure out how.
You don't know anything, do you?
Michael, it's me.
Who's this?
It's Peter, hi. I just saw him say hello.
Peter, don't you know what time it is? Where are you?
Well, I'm in New York.
Oh, I'm asleep. Call me all the time. Wait up.
No, I need to talk to you now.
Okay.
I was wondering, are you coming here soon?
No, I'm working here.
Well, I know, but I thought maybe you'd be working here sometime, or I don't know. Could take a vacation. It's just that
I want to see my old friend. Oh, well, yes, but not like you. I mean, I was with all these older people. I'm not so young myself anymore, I guess. I don't know.
Anyway, maybe I should go to L.A. You know, have some fun for a change.
You probably get some kind of a job out of it, don't you think? I mean, wouldn't it be great if the both of us, I mean, you and me, I mean, we sort of took a little trip out there, you know, check things out.
I'm not happy. Can't you call me some other time or write a letter?
What do you think about it?
No, what I said.
Sure, I'll think about it. Why are you only calling when you're fucked up?
I'm not fucked up. Because you're my friend.
Oh, Jesus. No, I'm not. I'm not your friend. I'm just another person to call up and complain to when you run out of everyone else. Mm-hmm. Don't you remember the last time you called like this?
Who cares about the last time? What do you want from me?
I don't want anything from you. That's just it. Good night.
Some surprises too.
Great.
I always like each time to be different.
Are you ready?
You'll see how ready I am.
Okay.
Find anything nice. I mean, I cannot live in one little room where everything is so expensive. I really like the Upper West Side, though. It's so pretty there, and everyone seems so together. I mean, I know this is an emerging neighborhood, but how long is it going to take? I mean, sometimes I think it's all just getting worse. So, where do you live?
Brooklyn.
Oh, really? Is it nice? I've never been on Manhattan.
It's okay.
Is it getting better there?
I'd say just the same as it always was.
Well, sense of stability is important. Would you like a drink?
Come here.
Let's wait. Do you want to dance? I feel like dancing.
Dancing's just a substitute for sex.
Well, I guess a lot of things are just a substitute for sex.
Maybe. So where are all the surprises you talked about?
Oh, let me put on my new favorite record first. I just bought it on Canal Street. You know, my mother, she used to play this song all the time. It's so...
It's so beautiful.
I don't know if I have anything.
Oh, come on. Don't give me that.
Well, you see, I don't really live here, and I'm not sure.
How about this?
Or I'll never fall in love. In a restless world like this is, love is ended before it's begun, and too many moonlight kisses seem to cool in the warmth of the sun. When I give my heart, it will be.
I
want to know what time it is now.